Hello students, so welcome back to the channel. In this video we are going to study about the types of the stems, aerial stems and the modifications, underground stem modifications, subaerial stem modification as well as aerial stem modification. So now see, first of all there are three forms of the aerial stem. They can be either reduced or they can be erect. And third category is ki they are the weak stem. Okay, so three categories are there. In reduced, you can remember the example of the reddish carrot or turnip in which the stem is highly reduced disc-like. Is it clear? This is the discoid stem which is highly reduced. And see, this is the root which has gone for modification to store food. Okay, this is the root. And here you are finding on this reduced stem, you are finding leaf is present. So these are the leaves which are present on this reduced discoid stem. So such leaves which are appearing to come from the reduced discoid stems, so these leaves are known as radical leaf. So this white color I've used for the reduced discoid stem, and this blue color is for the root topic. Okay, this is for the root. So this is root, and this is an example which I have taken is of carrot. So reduced stem is seen in the carrot. Another example is your radish. It is also seen in the turnip also. Reduced stem is also present in the onion. Check carefully. This is the onion in which the reduced discoid stem is there. And this is the central bud is present. Okay, this is the central bud, which is surrounded by the leafy sheet. These are the leaf base which is stored the food. So these are the leaf base which are storing the food. Fleshy leaf base. Clear, beta? They are fleshy leaf base which is store food, and this is your reduced discoid stem. And let me use another color. This is your bud. And this is finally covered with the dry tunic. This entire is covered by dry tunic. This dry covering is known as tunic. And inside is your fleshy leaf base. Fleshy leaf base. And this is giving rise to adventitious root. So these are the adventitious roots which comes. You can imagine you keep your onion in the kitchen for some time and you will find the adventitious roots are coming from it. Later on, you will find this bud is growing. This bud will grow and it will give rise to leafless shoot. And on top it will bear umbel inflorescence. Here flower will be there. Umbel inflorescence. So this leafless shoot is known as scape. The scape is nothing. It is leafless shoot which is coming from the apical bud. And this is an example of onion. So these are the few examples which are having reduced stem. Is it clear? Now let us discuss about the erect. If it is erect, it can be unbranched. Or it can be branched also. Unbranched, you can understand this way. This is your stem which is not going for branching. Okay. With nodes and internodes. And on top it is bearing the leaf. On top it is bearing the leaf. I think so, like a palm tree. So this is an example of the unbranched seen in the palm. Second, you can imagine this way. This is your stem with nodes are solid. Solid nodes but hollow internode. Okay. Solid nodes and hollow internodes. And this is an example of bamboo. So in this, what is the specialty in the bamboo? These nodes are solid. But internodes are hollow. This is internode area. This internodes are hollow. That is why if you remember in the olden days, the teacher used to carry the stick of the bamboo which used to be very broad, and we used to feel very scared the teacher will beat it. But when the teacher is hitting, he will hit from the internodal area, which is actually hollow, and it will not create much harm to the child. Now, such type of stem which is unbranched, present in the palm, it is known as cortex. In the palm, it is known as cortex, and in the bamboo, it is known as culm. So cortex and culm are the two types of the unbranched erect stem. Now see the branched one. See, this is your main stem. Okay, this is the main stem. And it is giving rise to the leaves. Branches are having, so leaves will be there. So here you are finding the old leaves. Okay, leaves are there. So if you're checking, we are getting a cone-shaped like diagram. We are getting a cone-shaped like diagram. So such type of diagram we see in the pine tree. So we are getting which type of canopy? If you check the diagram, you are getting a cone-shaped canopy. Canopy is cone-shaped. And apex is continuously growing, and young is present at the tip. And such type of condition is seen in the pine tree. It is seen in the Ashoka tree also. And such is known as branching. Such branching is known as excurrent. Excurrent branching, where the apex is continuously growing and the lateral branches are bearing the leaves, and the branches, lower branches are older as compared to the upper branches. Now see another type. Apex is stopped. Apex is not growing. Now branches are coming, which are bearing more and more leaves. So more leaves will be on the upper side. Old leaves will be on the upper side. This way it will be spreading, is going on. So as a result, you are getting umbrella shaped canopy. Okay, you are getting umbrella shaped canopy. So this umbrella shaped canopy is seen in banyan tree. You can see such in the mango tree also. Okay, and this type of branching, this type of branching is known as deliquescent. So two type of branchings are there, either excurrent or either deliquescent. So unbranched are of two type, cortex and culm. Same way, branch is also of two type, excurrent and deliquescent. Now let us see about the weak stem. Weak stem, they can be of four types. They can be twiner, or they can be clamber, they can be scramblers, and they can be lineas. Twiners are the one which will not use any clinching organs. The clinching organs are not there. Means no support organ. But clambers will use clinching organs. For examples, you can see they can use adventitious root. They can make adventitious root for climbing. An example is your beetle, which is also known as palm. They can use tendrils. Example is your grapes or passiflora. Okay. Twiners, if you see, check the diagram carefully now. See, this is your one stem. Okay. On which this twiners will be climbing. I'm just using different color. Wait. Now this twiner is going to climb on it. Check, this twiner is climbing on it. This weight is climbing. It is climbing this way. Understanding? And it is bearing the leaf. One condition. See the second condition also. Check carefully the diagram so that learning becomes easy for you. See here. Difference you might be finding in my drawing this way. If you see, this is disappearing. It is disappearing from your left side. This one. Okay, this one is disappearing from the left side. For you, it is appearing as if from your left, it is going inside. And it is appearing as if it is going from your right side. Okay, so such type of twiners are known as, let me just draw this much. This is known as sinistros. And this is known as dextros. This is also known as clockwise because it is moving in the clockwise direction. And this is anti-clockwise. So you can understand twiners this way, just like when a snake climbs around the tree. Na? Snake does not use any limbs or any organs, nothing. So what it is doing, it is actually going with the help of its body only, it's tightening the body around the plant. Okay, this is the way how the snake moves. So these twiners, they are moving up with the help of circumnutation. Circumnutation. It is a type of a movement in which the moment the tip is touching any organ, that area growth stops and opposite side growth occurs, as a result twisting occurs. Okay. And such conditions are not present in the climbers because they are using some support. They are using some clinching organs. Is it clear? Understood? Now, what is difference in the climber and scrambler? See, climbers are making use of either adventitious roots or tendrils, but scramblers are the one which are using curved thorns. They will use curved thorns. And such condition is seen in bougainvillea. Example is bougainvillea. And lineas are climbers when become woody. When the climbers becomes woody, generally the climbers who are climbing, their stem will be green in color. Okay, generally the climbers will be having the stem green in color, then only flexibility will be there. But lineas are the one in which climbers have also started showing secondary growth. So we will say woody climbers. They are known as lineas and they are generally seen in tropical rainforest, where continuously rain is there. As a result, they also go for secondary growth. So these are the different types of the stems. Okay. So these are the different forms of the stems. Now we will study stem modification. You can see this is an entire summary for what we discussed today. Form of aerial stems, they can be reduced or they can be erect. And third category, they can be weak. If they are erect, they are unbranched to caudex and culm. And if they are branched, then they are excurrent and deliquescent. Weak can be four categories: twiners, climbers, scramblers, and lineas. So I hope this mind map and this flowchart is easy for you to understand. Now let us move to the stem modifications. Now let us discuss a stem modification. First is underground stem modification. I'm giving you right now the mind map so that you can learn it properly. Underground stem modification are doing three functions. They are doing the storage of food. They are working as organ for perination. Perination means to escape unfavorable condition. And they are working as an organ for propagation, means for reproduction. So these are the functions they are performing. In this list is there rhizome, corm, bulb, and tuber. Then second category is subaerial stem modification. Subaerial stem modification work is only for propagation. Its main work is only propagation, which includes runner, sucker, stolon, and offset. Third category is aerial stem modification. Now in aerial stem modification, you are finding tendrils, thorns, hooks, phylloclade, cladode. These are the few examples of the aerial stem. Now let me give you the list of the examples, because in the competitive point the examples are very important. Okay, so let me give you the list. Now see the examples for rhizome. First of all, you know very well ferns, pteridophyte, Dryopteris, Equisetum. Okay, then other examples you can water lily, lotus, sugarcane also known as saccharum, ginger, turmeric, and canna. Okay, now for corm, colocasia, freesia, crocus. Crocus is also known as kesar. Okay, crocus is also known as kesar. Amorphophallus. And Amorphophallus, please note down, it is also known as jamikand. It is also known as elephant foot. And one more example is gladiolus. In the bulb, your example is your onion, garlic, tulip, narcissus, okay, and lily. In tuber, your example is potato, and artichoke. Potato will store starch, which is polysaccharide of the glucose, and artichoke will store inulin. Don't get confused with insulin, it is inulin. Inulin is your polymer of fructose. So these are the list of the examples of the underground stem modification. Okay, now let me give you the list of the subaerial stem modification. Now see the examples for this. Runner example is your grasses, oxalis. This is your diagram based NCRT diagram. Okay, NCRT has given the diagram given on the page 69. Oxalis and strawberry. Stolen example is your mint and jasmine. Sucker example is banana, pineapple, and chrysanthemum. And offset example is your pistia. Sorry, just a sec. Pistia and acornia. Acornia is also known as water hyacinth. And pistia is also known as water lettuce. All these examples are important from the NCERT point. Please learn it properly. Now let me give you the list for the aerial stem modification. See, with the aerial stem modification tendrils, axillary bud is making tendril in Passiflora, which we have already discussed in the bud area. Extra axillary cucurbits, apical buds, grapes, which is also known as Vitis vinifera, Vitis, okay? Floral bud, cardiospermum. These are the ones where the buds are making into tendrils. Hooks made by Ultrabotrys. Thorns will be made by Citrus, Bougainvillea, Duranta, and Pomegranate. And according to your NCERT, Citrus and Bougainvillea are there in your NCERT. Please learn properly also. Phylloclade and cladode. Phylloclade example is Opuntia, which is flat. It is again NCERT. And Euphorbia is actual cylindrical phylloclade. It is also NCERT example. Is it clear? Cladode made by the Ruscus and Asparagus. Now, what is difference in the phylloclade and cladode? See carefully. In phylloclade, main stem is becoming green in color. In phylloclade, main stem is green in color, whereas in cladode, it is a branch which is green in color. And when I'm saying main stem means it will show unlimited growth, and branch means it is showing limited growth. Is it clear, beta? So these are the few examples. See, cucurbit example is given in your NCERT. Axillary bud is modifying into tendrils. Passiflora example is there in your NCERT. So these are the few examples. Grapevine is your there. So these are the few examples of your NCERT which you need to learn properly. Now let me explain you in detail what is rhizome and what is corm. Now see the difference between rhizome and corm. Let us assume this is your soil, okay? So this is, I'm drawing a diagram of the ginger. This is your underground stem, which is going for branching. It is having branching also. So this is the way branching is there. With nodes are there, with long internodes. And you are finding at every node, adventitious roots are coming. These are the adventitious roots are coming. But in case of the corm, this is your soil and corm is present this way. Corm is not horizontal, corm is actually vertically. And it is bearing circular node with internode not too much big, they are very short internodes, and circular nodes are there. It is also giving rise to the adventitious root, but its adventitious roots are coming only from the lower node. Apart from the adventitious root, it is also having special type of root that is known as contractile roots or pull roots, which are maintaining the corm at a particular depth. Contractile roots are also known as pull root. Work is to maintain the corm at particular depth. It should not go too deep and it should not come above also. Here if you see in the rhizome diagram, in the ginger I have drawn the branching, but here in the corm I have not drawn branching, but it will have buds. And the buds are also having circular nodes. So basic difference between rhizome and corm is with respect to orientation in the soil and adventitious roots also. Now, one more thing I just want to emphasize here with respect to fern. In fern case, if you see, this is the soil and fern are having underground stem rhizome, which is oblique. They are having the oblique underground stem rhizome, okay? This is oblique is there, which is giving rise to adventitious roots. From every node it is coming out. Adventitious roots will come out from every node. But you have to focus here one thing, very important. The leaf which is coming out, it is actually coiled like a watch spring. And this is known as circinate vernation. Circinate vernation means coiled like a watch spring. And when the leaves become big, check my diagram carefully. When the leaves become big, then they are having, this is midrib, and the lateral vein are showing open dichotomous branching, which are not touching the margin. Check the diagram carefully, they are not touching the margin. And this type of venation is known as forkate venation. Forkate venation. The fern leaves will have circinate vernation in the young condition, means coiled like a watch spring, and they are having forkate venation, means network of vein and veinlet in such a way that tip is lateral vein are going for open dichotomous branching and they are not touching the margin. Is it clear? So difference between the rhizome and corm is clear. Now let us see the difference between the bulb and tumor. See here, this is your soil. Let us assume this is a soil, okay? And this is the stem. This part of the stem has also gone underground. These are the nodes areas. Obviously between the nodes, internodes will be there. And these are the your taproot, normal taproot, okay? These are your normal taproots, which has gone for branching and all. They are not adventitious. Please remember, they are not adventitious. They are normal roots. Now from here, I'm using blue color purposely because it's a stem part. This branch is coming and tip of the branch. Branch means it is also having node and internode. Tip of the branch swell up to store food. This is how the potato formation is going on. The tip of the branch will swell up to store food. Is it clear? And when you see here, you're finding this is a node area in potato, which are known as eyes of potato. Very important question area, which vegetable has eyes? Potato will be the answer. These are known as eyes of potato. And if you check in this diagram, I'm not drawing any adventitious root. So very important, adventitious roots are absent here. Adventitious roots are absent in underground stem only in case of tuber. Otherwise, adventitious root will always be present. Now, when you see the eye of potato, you are finding, let me draw this eye outside. You are finding it is having one axillary bud. I think so, you know very well what is axillary means. And it is having two accessory bud, which already I have explained in the video. These are the accessory bud, and what is accessory in the previous video already I explained. So accessory buds are there, and this is your axillary bud. And this is the eye of potato. Is it clear? Now, but when you see the onion in the bulb case, example, if you remember onion, this is your reduced discoid stem, which is having the apical bud. This is the apical bud, and it is surrounded by a leaf base, which are fleshy leaf base. Edible part is your fleshy leaf base. Is it clear? These are the fleshy leaf base, and they are finally covered by one more layer, which is dry, and this dry is known as tunic. This dry is known as tunic. Dry tunic. And it is also giving rise to adventitious root. These are the adventitious roots. From here, the adventitious root will come with the reduced discoid stem, which I've already explained you upside only. And this is the bud which is going to give rise to leafless shoot and on top it is bearing umbel inflorescence. This you will be studying in detail in the inflorescence video, but you just learn here, this is your leafless shoot known as scape. Here if you are finding only one tunic, so this is known as simple tunicated bulb. Simple tunicated bulb. The simple tunicated bulb example is your onion. But in case of garlic, you are finding they are present around individual also as well as around whole. So garlic is your compound tunicated bulb. Garlic. And if you see in the lily, the tunic is not present only. So we say naked bulb. The naked bulb is present in lily. So I hope explanation of all the underground stem modification is clear to you. Now let us discuss the subaerial stem modification. Nana, try to understand, this is a soil, okay? Let us assume this is a soil and this is your lawn grass. This is a stem. Just touching to the soil, it is never losing connection with the soil. And these are the node area. From every node area, adventitious roots will come out. Okay, these are the adventitious roots and you will see leaves are coming. Your lawn grass, when you are moving in the park and everywhere, you are finding this is the runner going on. Now see the difference between the runner and stolon. Check the diagram very carefully. This is your stem, sorry, this is your soil. And let us assume this is one piece of some obstacle present. This is an obstacle, one stone is present. Then see the stem condition, check. It will arch over it, okay? It will arch over it and see carefully the part of the stem which is in the air, means which is losing connection with the soil. See what I'll be drawing it. You will not find adventitious root in that area. The part which is in the air is not bearing any adventitious root, but the part, the moment it touches the soil, it again gives rise to adventitious root. So now here, this is the leaf. So basic difference between the runner and the stolon is, the stolon can be in the air for some time. And this property of the stolon, we are using for the layering purpose. Artificially, we are doing layering based on the stolon concept, which you will be studying in detail in your 12th class. Okay. Now see for sucker, try to understand this is your soil. Okay. This is a soil. And this is your part of the stem which is going underground. Okay. This is the part of the stem which is going underground. So from this part of this, one branch is coming. Branch is coming and this is actually a branch, means node will be there and it is growing obliquely upward. It is growing obliquely upward. Okay. And it is now going to be the leaf here. It is going to be the leaf here. So this is actually my example of this sucker. Sucker means it is coming from the underground soil and finally one branch is coming and it is coming up aerial after growing obliquely. After some distance it is traveling horizontal, then it is becoming obliquely upward. Now see, last is your offset. Offset is actually only one long internode runner. Only one long internode runner, only this much, which is having, these are your adventitious root. Okay, this is the adventitious root. And this is actually, now see diagram carefully. This is your basal lamina, okay, leaf base. This is petiole and this is lamina. This is your leaf base. This is petiole and this is lamina. Understood? Once again, this is leaf base, short petiole and this is lamina. So this is actual example of your acornia. And I told you acornia is also known as terror of Bengal because it was introduced in India only because of its twisted shaped leaves. Is it clear? I hope this topic is clear to you. Thanks for watching.